Now we'll look at some examples of solving quadratic equations using square roots. Our first equation, we have x squared equals 36. And since x squared is a perfect square, we can solve this equation by using square roots. And if we have x squared equals 36, we can solve this equation for x if we take the square root of both sides of the equation. And now if we simplify, the square root of x squared would be equal to x. The square root of 36 is equal to 6. But there's one more thing to remember when solving an equation by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. We need to add a plus or minus sign here to show that x can equal positive 6 or negative 6, because remember the original equation was x squared equals 36. And positive 6 squared and negative 6 squared is equal to positive 36. Another way to explain why we need this plus or minus sign here is this is actually the principal square root of x squared, which means this must be positive, so it's actually equal to the absolute value of x. So we have the absolute value of x equals the square root of 36, which is equal to 6. And then if we were to solve this equation, we would have x equals positive 6 or x equals negative 6. It's not often shown this way, but this is the real reason why we have to include a plus or minus sign when taking the square root of both sides of an equation. And one more thing to mention here, because our two solutions are real and rational, we actually could have solved this quadratic equation by setting it equal to 0 and factoring. But this video is going to focus on using square roots to solve these types of equations. Looking at our second equation, we want to isolate x squared, so we need to start by adding 256 to both sides of the equation. So we'd have x squared, this would be 0, equals 256. And now because x squared is a perfect square, we can solve this for x by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. And when doing so, this time, I'll include the plus or minus sign here. So the square root of x squared is x, equals plus or minus, 256 is actually a perfect square. 256 is equal to 16 times 16. So the square root of 256 is equal to 16. So our two solutions are x equals 16 or x equals negative 16. In our next equation, we want to solve this for x squared. So we need to divide both sides of the equation by 25. So we'd have x squared equals 54 over 25. And now to solve this for x, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation, add our plus or minus sign here. So we have x equals, we can rewrite this as plus or minus the square root of 54 divided by the square root of 25. And notice that 25 is a perfect square. So the denominator simplifies to the square root of 25, or 5. 54 is not a perfect square, but it does contain perfect square factors, so this will simplify. 54 is equal to 9 times 6, and 9 is a perfect square, so this simplifies to x equals plus or minus 3 square root 6, the square root of 9 is equal to 3, divided by 5. And here, because we have two real irrational solutions, this tells us that we could not have solved this equation by factoring. And for our last example, we'll solve this equation for x squared by dividing both sides by 2. So we have x squared equals 7 halves. And now again, to solve this for x, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation, include the plus or minus sign on the right. So the square root of x squared is x. And again, we can write this as plus or minus the square root of 7 divided by the square root of 2. Notice these don't simplify, but often we do want to rationalize the denominator, meaning we want to eliminate the square root in the denominator. The only way this would simplify nicely is if there were two factors of 2 rather than 1. So we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by the square root of 2. So we'll have x equals plus or minus. Notice in the numerator we'll have the square root of 7 times the square root of 2. That's the square root of 14. Then the square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is equal to the square root of 4, which simplifies to 2. Okay, we'll take a look at some more examples of these types of problems in the next video. I hope you found these helpful.